Hello friends, welcome to eKida. Title of the lecture is Ferranti Effect. So what is Ferranti Effect? So the effect in which the voltage at the receiving end of the transmission line is more than the sending end voltage, this effect is known as the Ferranti Effect. Such type of effect mainly occurs because of light load or open circuit at the receiving end. So when no load or light load condition, occurs, then terminal voltage in a transmission line will be greater than the supply voltage, means VR is greater than VS. So this Ferranti effect, why it comes? So Ferranti effect is due to the charging current of the line. See, you all know what is this charging current. In transmission line will have a series resistance as well as reactance and effect of capacitance is also there. This is R, XL and this is C. This capacitance will found between the conductors and between the conductor and the earth. So generally this effect, this current that is passing through this capacitance, this is known as charging current. When an alternating voltage is applied, the current that flows into the capacitor is known as the charging current. And this charging current is also known as the capacitive current. Suppose this is voltage V. So this capacitance will be equal to the voltage applied across this. So this is V omega C. So it depends on value of capacitor as well as value of voltage. So this value of voltage increases or value of length increases because like this, many capacitors are connected in parallel. This is not the only capacitor. Many capacitors are connected in parallel because capacitance formed at each and every point. See, this Ferranti effect occurs because capacitance and inductance are the main parameters of the line. So, having length of 200 km and above. So, on such transmission line, capacitance is not concentrated at some definite point. It is distributed uniformly along the whole length of the line. So, when capacitors are connected in parallel, like there are many capacitors. So when capacitors are connected in parallel, they will add to each other, or the total value of capacitance C will be the capacitance per unit length into total length. And when the length of the transmission line increases, then effect of the charging will be more. Charging current will be more due to this Ferranti effect. For short transmission line, length is less. As well as voltage is less, Ferranti effect can be neglected for short transmission line. But for medium and long transmission line, charging current cannot be neglected. Now detailed explanation of the Ferranti effect by considering a nominal pi model. So this is R, L and this is capacitor. That's why it is known as nominal pi model. So this is the sending end voltage. This is sending end current. This is receiving end voltage. So this is Y by 2, and this Y is equals to J omega C by 2 into length. So this is L. For a long transmission line into length L. So this is also equals to y by 2. This is also equals to j omega c into L by 2, where L is the length of the line. So this conductance, so this y is equals to j omega c by 2 into L, where L is the length of the transmission line. So this y is equals to j omega c into L by 2, and in this equivalent circuit, conductance is neglected. You know this, only capacitance considered properly. So under light load condition, IR is equals to 0. So how much value of the capacitive current that is passing through this? So this charging current, this is IC. So this IC charging current, this is equals to V into Y by 2, where V is the voltage. So this V into Y by 2, so we know Y is equals to J omega C into L by 2. Now draw the phasor diagram, taking VR as reference. So this is VR as reference. So under light load condition, IR is equals to 0, and taking VR as reference, so IC is 90 degree perpendicular to VR. This is IC, which is 90 degree perpendicular to this VR. So now this ICR is in phase with IC. So this is ICR. And now ICR plus ICXL. And because of this J component is coming, this is 90 degree. This is 90 degree ICXL. Now the sum of VR plus ICR plus ICXL, this is equals to VS. So resultant end of this voltage gives sending value of voltage, and it is clearly seen from this phasor diagram that VS is less than VR. VS, this VS is less than VR. Now we'll see this VS is less than VR. With some expression, this Vs is equals to Vr plus Vr into Y by 2. This Vr voltage at the receiving end into Y by 2. This is the value of IC, charging current, and into Z. This gives a sending end voltage. So see, this Vs equals to Vr plus Vr into Y by 2. This Vr into Y by 2. This is the value of the charging current, Vr into Y by 2, and into Z, this gives the sending end voltage, IC into Z. So this is equals to Vs is equals to Vr common 1 plus YZ by 2. Or we can write this as Vs minus Vr, this is equals to Vr YZ by 2, where we know that this Z is equals to R plus J omega L into length of the line, and Y is equals to J omega C into L length of the line by 2. This Vs minus Vr. Now we can write this equation as Vs minus Vr. This is equals to Vr by 2. Multiply this R plus J omega L into L into J omega C into L. So this is equals to this is equals to J omega R C L square minus, because this J into J square is minus 1, so this plus is minus 1, into omega square L C into L square. So this first term, there are two components. First component, this is due to resistance. And second component, this component is in phase opposition to the value of VR, and it is having negative sign, means opposite direction. So if you take any transmission line, see this R is very very less than 2XL. So neglect the value of R. So this Vs minus VR, this is equals to minus VR by 2 omega square L square L C. Neglect this R because R is small very very small than XL. So we neglect the R. So Vs minus VR is equals to minus V R by 2 omega square L square into L C. And we know, so this Vs minus VR, this is equals to minus VR by 2 omega square L square L C. So this negative sign indicates that VR is greater than Vs. Receiving end voltage is greater than Vs. This negative sign indicates that. So how to reduce this Ferranti effect? See, electrical devices are designed to work at some particular voltage. If voltage are high at the user end, their equipment get damaged and their windings burn because of this high voltage. So Ferranti effect on long transmission line at low load or no load increases the receiving end voltage. This voltage can be controlled by placing the shunt reactors at the receiving end. Of the lines. So these shunt reactor is an inductive current element connected between line and the neutral to compensate the capacitive current from transmission lines. These shunt reactors is an inductive current element. It is an inductive current element. So this shunt reactor is an inductive current element which is connected between the line and the neutral to compensate the capacitive current or charging current IC from transmission lines. Thank you.